There is a bitterness in people that is sat deep-rooted from past hurts that is sitting in people at this very moment, in this very congregation, as I speak, that God wants to release you from this morning. Do you hear me very carefully, for those that are now hearing this? That he wants to release you from. It's not having a go. It is saying you need to be released from it this morning. It's a bitterness that can only be released supernaturally. It is not something you can work through yourself.
This is GBC Web TV. On the internet at gbcweb.tv. Welcome to Greenford Baptist Church in West London. Here you can watch inspiring biblical teaching and other excellent Christian videos. You can order the teaching video DVDs, listen to and study the audio versions of these, or download them as audio podcasts to your computer or MP3 player. Today's inspiring and biblical teaching is called Don't Be Dim by Warren McNeil.
You are the light of the world. Those words you just heard that were read to us were the words of Jesus in Matthew. And he was talking to the church, to us. If you're a Bible-believing Christian, then he was talking, those words were talking to you. You are the light of the world. Do you agree so far?
Yes.
Okay, good, thank you. A city on a hill cannot be hidden. Is that true? If you see a city on a hill, it can't be hidden. Yeah? Good. There's a city. Wouldn't quite say it's on a hill, but there's a city. Do you know which city it is? Sorry?
London.
Excellent. Yes, it is London. And it's at night. And it has lots of little lights. Did you notice that? Can you see it? It's got lots of lights all in the buildings. Let's not go into energy conservation, shall we? In the middle of London. And the rest of the chapter passes on. Neither do people light a lamp and put it under a bowl. Instead, they put it on its stand, and it gives light to everyone in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before men, that they may see your good deeds and praise your Father in heaven. Amen. Absolutely. Well, this is London, at night, with some lights on. I don't know about you, but there's a lot of darkness in this world. Yes? There's a lot of darkness in this world. And we're the lights that are going to shine into it. Because Jesus uses us that. What's that? It's a bit hard to see, really, on the big screen. I can see it great on here, by the way. I'm doing really well. That's an aerial view of London. With the lights on. Can you see the M25? Just round there? Yeah. So I gather, sort of, can you see that really spurring bit of light just shooting off? Hang on a minute. There. Can you see that? My assumption was that was the M40. I travel it a lot, so that's my assumption that it is. So that's the M40. So that's us. And I liked the fact on this picture that there was lots of light spreading into the darkness, giving light into the darkness. With me so far? Everybody like that picture? Go to Google Images, and that's where you find it, and just put in night, London, and you'll find it. There you go. The city on the hill is us, it's church. Church is the city on the hill. We in Greenford are city on the hill. Yes? Those are members here?
Yes.
We're the ones to be shone, and we are the city on the hill. The light is this, as far as I'm concerned, for this particular illustration this morning, is us individually. You might have just left the membership of Greenford recently. Hello, Naomi. But you can still be included in this, it's fine, because you still live within South London. You'll be all right. But the light, the individual light, that's us. Do you consider yourself to be a light?
Yes.
Do you really?
Yes.
Yes, interesting. Yeah, I'm the same as you, Joan. Some people go, well, yes, I do, but others are like, well, I don't know, really. Am I a light? You're meant to be. Meant to be a light for God. Where's that? Thank you, Steve. I believe it's Ruislip Road. It didn't actually describe it. It just said Greenford at night. It's amazing. Greenford is on Google Images. I thought that was quite something, really. I don't know where it is, neither. We can sit here all night and discuss specifically where it is, but I don't know where it is. But that's Greenford, and I found that quite dark, really. I looked at that and thought there's a real sort of darkness, but there is a light that's sort of coming just up and over there. And our area here needs Jesus' light. Amen?
Amen?
Needs Jesus' light. And it rests with us and our fellow other brothers and sisters in other churches. I'm not excluding them that go to other congregations that suits their needs. But it does rest with us. I like the fact that Richard this morning, I had no idea he was going to give the notice about the carnival and the prayer event. But I want you to, while I was thinking about this morning, I think I was very keenly thinking about the carnival and us being light, salt and light, but light in the carnival and allowing God to use us in that area. You're all sitting there with that sort of stunned look to sort of say, really? Yes, we are. Let your light shine before men. Matthew 5, verse 16. That is our duty to do that. Sounds hard, heavy, but that is our duty to do that. Is to allow our light, God's light, through us to shine before men. I very much keenly believe that God works in sort of partnership with us in the respect of seeing his will being fulfilled. In the respect of, we are given free will, are we not? We as humans, we're different from the beasts and the birds, etc. In the main respect that we are given free will. We are able to make choices. So we can actually make a choice as to whether we do what God wants us to do or not. Yeah, if we want God to work through us, and we have the ability to make that choice. God doesn't always work just without us or beside us. If that was the case, he wouldn't need us to carry out his word to other people. Is that not true? He uses us. It's a partnership. It's a father to child, lord to servant relationship. He expects us to go out and allow his light to shine through us before men. For those that are into energy conservation, I put up an energy-saving bulb. Yeah? Everybody got one of those in their house? I'm overloaded with them. Anyway, that's enough of that, because I don't think God's into energy-saving, per se, when it comes down to his Holy Spirit being used. Do you?
No.
What's that? A what? A dimmer switch. What does a dimmer switch do? Come on, you lot are normally louder than this. Especially you, boss, eh? Come on, what?
Lighter or brighter?
Lighter or brighter? Lighter or brighter? That's what a dimmer switch does, doesn't it? You walk into the room, you initially turn it, and you can turn it up to full crank. To allow the full bulb to shine. No? Then we've got seen a dimmer switch, used it before?
Yeah?
No, Joan? Never had a dimmer switch. Do you still use candles? Oh, sorry. Love you, sorry.
I'm not sure I love you.
I'm going to need to repent later. A dimmer switch. I haven't got one in our house anymore. We used to have it in our old flat that we used to live in. It used to be an absolute nightmare. Absolutely, thing used to wind me up because it never worked properly. And then I discovered it was my poor wiring. But anyway, dimmer switch. We, I think, I think God's saying this morning that some of us all have dimmer switches set for the light that Jesus has put into us, for the light that we can shine out. All of us that are here have our own internal dimmer switch. And we can choose whether to turn it on full blast to allow God to work through, or to turn it down and not allow God to work through. When I was thinking and praying for this morning, I thought, dimmer switch? Well, dimmer switch, I know how it works. You turn the knob and you turn it back on again. Well, no, this is how a dimmer switch works. We're going to have a quick electrical lesson. Who's an electrician here? Anybody an electrician of any way, shape or form? No, a qualified electrician who knows how a dimmer switch works. Good, I'm safe. So if I get this wrong, fine. Excellent. Okay. A dimmer switch. Now, if you notice, this is really good. Again, that's God bless Google Images. Very useful. This is the knob bit of the dimmer switch, and this is the internal workings. So you have there a variable resistor. Do you know what the variable resistor does? Stab a guess at it. One at a time. Andy. It does resist the electricity, that's right, absolutely. But it's variable. You can change it to your own requirements and how you are doing. That's what it does on a dimmer switch. I'm glad there's no electricians here and get away with this morning. But that's what it does. The variable dimmer switch, it allows you to vary the amount of power that flows through to the light bulb in the light switch. It allows the power. The 240 volts that run your lights still go to the light switch, still go to the dimmer switch. But you're able to adjust how much of that power flows through by the resistor. So what about us? We're all spirit-filled, those that believe in Jesus, we're all spirit-filled Christians and have tapped into the unlimited resources of the Holy Spirit. Do you agree? This is the same Spirit that was around at the time of the Father and of the Son that created and sustains our universe to which we live in and to which we are an incredibly small part of. But a significant small part. And we can tap in. We are given. It lives in us. It breathes through us. It guides us and it helps us. Is this Holy Spirit? Do you agree? Holy Spirit being the 240 volts... If you want to say, the Holy Spirit is a person as well, but it's a 240 volt. Well, he's a lot bigger than that, and he's a lot more powerful than 240 volts. But you see where I'm going. And we can limit and adjust how that 240 volts flows once it gets to us. Once it gets to our switches, we can decide how much we want to allow it to shine the light. Now, I struggled over this this week when I was thinking about this because I thought, yes, I at times turn my switch right down. So it's a very, very dim glow that's coming out. I choose to limit it. But we got this carnival coming, and there's something about this carnival, people. Listen very, 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 very closely. There is something about us at this carnival on the 5th of July. As a city on a hill, as a people of light, that God is going to use us. God is going to use us to spread his word. It's not for our glory, it's not for our feeling wonderful, but it is for his glory. So people are released from the oppression of not knowing Jesus. And that should get everybody excited. Amen. No, really should get everybody excited. Let's go again. Should get everybody excited. Yeah. Thank you. Lord bless them. But it's true. We should be excited. We sit there worrying about the fact. I love a lot of the songs that we sing. I do enjoy some of the worship songs, but they seem to dampen down and mellow out how God is. They're all nice. Some of them are nice. Indescribable is probably about the only one at the moment, I think, that really sort of says, yeah, how big our God is and how much he can do. And he does it through us. Does it through because of our prayers. Does it through because we're willing to stand and to be and allow him to use us. But we've got to have our dimmer switches cranked up full blast. I actually said to God this week, remove me dimmer switch and just hot wire me straight in. That'd be useful. Yeah? Yeah. But being honest, do you turn your dimmer switch down? Yeah. Is your variable resistor, whatever your resistor consists of, that's the thing. What does your variable resistor consist of? It could be fear. That's always normally the fairly standard one for us. It could be laziness, let's be honest. Apathy, thank you ever so much. This is why I'm glad everybody's here. Well done. Apathy, laid backness about it. Not really that bothered. Doesn't affect me directly, so I don't need to worry about it. You're wrong. The darkness in this world affects everybody. And so at this carnival especially, we need to be prepared to have our switches cranked up full blast and allowing the full 240 volts of the Holy Spirit to go to our light bulbs and to shine and to be used and to spread light. If it sounds like a nag, it's not meant to be. It's meant to be an absolute truth. I don't like carnivals. I'll be absolutely honest and real. I don't like them. I have avoided going to Greenford Carnival as many times as I possibly could. I then got a girl and a daughter who longs to go to carnival, so I have to go. I don't like them. I don't like the atmosphere, to be honest. But this year, I am so looking forward to it because I think the atmosphere is going to be different. Amen. Because we're going to be there spreading God's light. Amen. We are, aren't we, church?
Yes.
If you hadn't planned to be there, can I suggest you do? And to listen to what Richard had to say about the praying and the fasting, etc. And, you know, thank you, Richard. So, but God's asked us to turn up our dimmer switches to full blast. Now, there is something else up there called the triac. Do you see that? That little innocuous thing at the top, yeah? Everybody can see that? It's called triac. I presume that's how it's spelt as I was trying to read how it works. That's a triac. The triac also is part of the dimmer switch. And this is what the triac does. It separates the voltage, so to make the light appear dimmer than it is. Okay? So it works in conjunction with the resistor, as far as I can make out. Anybody that's watching this on the internet, if you're an electrician and I've got this wrong, don't email me, thank you. But it does separate the thing. Now, the triac would appear to me to be quite a little static little innocuous thing that just sits inside the switch. Would you agree? The resistor, variable resistor and the inductor choke and all those things are quite large. They're quite big on this switch, you know, nice round, compared to the little triac. But it separates the voltage as to make the light appear dimmer than it is. It seems to obviously limit the amount of voltage that goes through. And that can't seem to be adjusted by the looks of it, by the switch. We can't seem to do whatever that do. Anybody know what that is? Yeah. Everybody's just going, why has it gone from a dimmer switch to Darth Vader? For those that know me well, know that I'm very much into science fiction. Star Wars is one of my favourite. I had to shoehorn it in somehow. No, I didn't. Just bear with me on this one. So said, a triac, which is on the dimmer switch, is a noxious little thing that separates the voltage. I want you to explain to you about Darth Vader. And the character that's behind him is called Anakin Skywalker. And there's another picture. That's Anakin Skywalker as a little boy. For those who are not into sci-fi, just listen to me just very, very briefly and listen to this. Can you see how that shadow doesn't look very much like Anakin Skywalker, does it not? No, it's the shadow of Darth Vader. Let me explain to you. Anakin Skywalker was in the stories. It's all science fiction. It's all make-believe. None of this is real. But just hear me out just for a moment. Anakin Skywalker was a boy who grew up in slavery. Effectively, his mum was a slave and he was a slave. And went through a lot of pain living in some world that just doesn't suit them at all. Had a very painful life, very painful beginning, and had some hurt and some pain being affected. Probably not nice being a slave and being tied down. And that's what happened. But Anakin Skywalker had this fantastic potential to become the greatest Jedi Knight possible, to have unlimited tapping in to something called the Force. I do not, and I'll make this very clear, I am not relating a science fiction story anything like God, the Holy Spirit, and Jesus Christ, okay? Hear me very, very clearly. I just want you to listen to a fictional character for a moment. And he had this potential to be the greatest Jedi Knight, to spread all the goodness, the honesty, to do everything that needed to be done as a good Jedi Knight does. That's the potential he had. To have the Force, which was this... For those who don't know, it was a mythical thing. It was like a sort of you could lift, levitate things, control people, but it was something to be used for good and not for anything else. And that was the idea of it. Okay? And he had this. But the problem was he had a very deep-seated anger inside of him because of some stuff that happened to him when he was younger. The fact he was in slave trade, the fact that he didn't see his mum that often, and him and his mum did not have a very nice life. And that sat with him as he grew up, and as he grew up, and as he grew up. Now, he got taken away to be trained to be a Jedi Knight, to basically be a priest as such. That's the sort of the analogy they try and put together between the two. And he had this fantastic potential to be the greatest good guy you could possibly get, to spread justice through the galaxy. Problem is, he had this deep-seated anger and bitterness that was inside of him. And it grew with him as it grew. And it affected every area of his life. He was never truly happy. If you ever watch the movie, he'd never, or reads the books, he was never happy. It affected every relationship he had. And he had this rotten thing inside of him, this rotten core that was never going to be changing. And it was going to change him and change him. And he was never going to be able to become the full potential he wanted to be. Unfortunately, it got so bad that eventually he turned into Darth Vader. Darth Vader, all black suited, yeah? Full black outfit, completely hidden. Wonderful image of somebody with a vengeful, vengeful bitterness who doesn't know how to enjoy life. Lots of deep breathing going on. And not a very nice character. Because bitterness that was inside of him right at the beginning sat in him and never got dealt with. Never got dealt with by him. Never got dealt with within him. And I likened that to the triac. The little triac that helps separate the voltage and dims the light within us. And God is saying this morning, when I was praying about this, that there is, and he means this lovingly, there is bitterness in some people here this morning that is separating the voltage and allowing them to be used fully. There is a bitterness in people that is sat deep-rooted from past hurts, that is sitting in people at this very moment, in this very congregation, as I speak, that God wants to release you from this morning. Do you hear me very carefully for those that are now hearing this? That he wants to release you from. It's not having a go. It is saying you need to be released from it this morning. It's a bitterness that can only be released supernaturally. It is not something you can work through yourself. It is something that can only be released supernaturally. You cannot work it through the situation yourself. It is so deep-rooted in you, you cannot remove it. Feels like to you maybe a little thing that just rears its head every now and again. But it's actually, like the triac in that dimmer switch, it sits there permanently, separating your joy, separating your happiness, and most keenly of all, separating the light that God has put within you, that he can use to its fullness and to its greatness and to its strength. But at the moment, the bitterness that is sitting within you, and I don't know what that bitterness is and why it's there, but it's an anger that has formed into bitterness and it is just sitting there. And you've tried to deal with it. God is saying, I know there are people that have tried to deal with it. You can't. You need to, A, admit it to other people and allow him to deal with it supernaturally for you this morning. I normally like to give a personal story, but I don't have one, hence why I have to use a fictional character. But with this I do know, that this is what God wants for this morning for people. Whoever are, you're living with this bitterness sitting in you, this anger sitting in you. And it's making you miserable. God doesn't want us to be miserable. He wants to do something about it this morning. Now, if you don't know God, and this morning something about that bitterness has hit you, we believe in a God who can change things. Supernaturally make an impact in your life and change things. Doesn't mean that every person here who does know God has actually got it sorted, because this is talking to people here that do know Jesus Christ as well. But if you don't know God as your personal, if you don't know Jesus Christ as your personal Saviour, he wants to sort that out with you this morning as well. And that bitterness, that anger, that deep seed that's sitting within you, he wants to come and sort that out with you as well. But you've got to come to him. Because he loves you, by the way. That's why he wants to sort it out. But this morning, we're going to be calling on God this morning. And I believe God's already here this morning. I know he's here. And he wants to sort out the deep-rooted bitterness and anger that are in some people in a supernatural way. There was this, when I was doing the research for this, there was this great quote in one of the pictures, and it's to do with cooking. I'm not into cooking, but it's to do with cooking. And it says, very, very simple, to reduce bitterness in your food, add salt. And I thought, that's interesting, to add salt. And if you look in verse 13, before anything else, it says, you are the salt of the earth. But if the salt loses its saltiness, how can it be made salty again? And this sounds harsh, but it's no longer good for anything except to be thrown out and trampled by men. God doesn't want that this morning. God doesn't want anybody to be trampled and thrown out. He's saying, I want to sort out the bitterness that's inside of you, but it can only be done supernaturally. And I am the salt, and I will come and reduce the bitterness. I will come and extract the bitterness. I will add the flavour that's inside of you. I will put flavour into you. And people, I don't want us to limit this morning. Those that are leaders here, those that are going to be coming and praying for people. Let's not limit what God can do. Let's turn up our dimmer switches to full blast this morning. Let's allow God to work through us in faith. I believe there's going to be a real supernatural thing of God working this morning. God is here this morning. I'm going to ask Faddy in a moment just to play that song we heard earlier, that whole track again. And then it's just going to play. And so just for now, he's going to play it quietly. And just for now, I just want you to spend some time with God. And don't be scared if that's really hit you this morning. What I've said, and you know God is talking to you this morning, and there are people here that God has spoken to this morning, don't hold back. But let's just listen to this for a moment, just for a while, and just let's just talk to God. Thank you, Faddy. Get rid of all bitterness, rage and anger. Faddy, carry on. If that's you this morning, God's very clearly spoken to you this morning. We're going to play a song. Believe that God is here this morning, very, very much so. And want you to come forward to hear and meet with God. To meet with God. Come to the foot of his cross and meet with him this morning. Allow him to supernaturally deal with this for you this morning. So can we all be standing, please? And as this song plays, if that's for you, come forward, and people are willing to pray for you. And for those that are going to pray for people, release is a thing that we need to pray for.
We do hope you've enjoyed and benefited from this presentation. To learn more about what the Bible teaches us and how to apply this to our everyday lives, check out our biblical teaching and other videos at gbcweb.tv. And before you go, an invitation especially for you. Why not visit us at Greenford Baptist Church on the corner of Beechwood Avenue and Ruislip Road in Greenford, West London, the United Kingdom. Our postcode is UB69UA. Our phone number is 020 8575 5034 and our TV website is gbcweb.tv. We look forward to seeing you soon.